So you remember it used to be, well, if you saw the first video, you remember it was mounted to a piece of plywood. And now, take the plywood off. And this is what we have. So this is the new back. It's two pieces of steel that was laser cut. And there's a link in the description to where I ordered it. It was actually pretty reasonably priced. At first I had ordered one piece to be the frame, and then I realized that there's actually, it's not completely flat. The top here is slightly higher than the rest of the holes around the perimeter. So there's a second piece that I ordered that basically goes around the bottom and the two sides. You can see there's just one layer here, and then starting here you get two layers. This was a little bit higher, and then these all, the rest are lower, so they have two stacked pieces. And it kind of closes that gap so that this top piece is now level and flush. Yeah. And I made holes for all the spots on the panel so you can screw into them. This one was a little tricky. I think I misaligned the holes between the two different ones, and I couldn't, I have to drill it out a bit wider to just be able to hit that hole. But the rest of them were pretty good. I made a hole here that I ended up not using because I ended up putting the remote control board right here over it. So I ended up drilling two holes here and a hole up here to mount this. I would probably add two more holes or three more holes here ahead of time so I didn't have to drill them, but yeah, didn't have the foresight. I didn't know where this was gonna go yet when I ordered it. So you see the remote control board, that's just the cable connector I couldn't really move, and then the IR receiver for the remote, and then we got power, and then we have like all the menu buttons here, and then there's an LED right there, and then when you want to hide it, just push it. So yeah, works pretty well. This could be better though, and from the front it's completely hidden. I cut out a little square here for the backlight. I think in version 3, I could probably hide this cable by having a little bit of a cutout to let it go underneath here. I was trying to keep this pretty thin, at least as thin as I could, reasonably. But that made some things a little difficult to mount this VESA mount for my arm here. I didn't want the screws to touch the actual panels, so there's a little bit of a gap, but it was really close. And then screwing this enclosure on, it was a little tricky as well because the screws were close. So yeah, maybe version 3 won't be as thin to make it a little bit easier. Yeah, part of me is thinking maybe this enclosure could actually be closer to the panel, and then the whole thing could be the thickness of this enclosure roughly. Yeah, not sure. This is the cable that goes from the board to the panel itself, and it's kind of just floating behind this frame. This cable, I kind of just wrapped it up here and zip tied it to this, and it goes, it turns and goes down into the control board. Another thing that I'm thinking about is maybe redoing this in a way where this cable doesn't have to move every time, but that would mean I'd have to create maybe my own board and maybe piggyback the connections to the buttons on from this board to that one, and then just have this one mounted fixed somewhere here in the back. And then, yeah, let me flip this over so you can see. So, yeah, the steel definitely makes it a little on the heavy side, but not too bad. You can see like the thickness. I don't know if it's, come on, can you focus? Yeah, it's pretty thin. So let's flip this over. And then from the front, it's basically just the panel. No extra bezels or anything sticking out the sides. So you can hide it and pull it down. It kind of locks in place with magnets, so it kind of has a satisfying click to it. What else? So you'll see all the ports here. This is power. We got two USB 2.0s. If you use the USB-C connection, and then you want to do like a keyboard and mouse to this, I think that's what these are for. I'm not sure. We got HDMI 2.0, two of them. We got two DisplayPort 1.4. So you can do full 5K out of just one cable from here, which is nice. And then USB-C, it has 65 watts of power delivery. And then this is just an audio jack. So if you wanted to do speakers, or that's another possible idea. Do I want to put speakers on here? So if I made the whole enclosure, maybe like the thickness of this box for the driver board, that would probably give me enough space to do something like speakers, but I don't necessarily need it. This enclosure itself is about 21 millimeters. So it wouldn't be terribly thick. So something to think about. It would work on any base amount, really. It's 100 millimeters by 100 millimeters square for the VESA, which is standard. One of the benefits to having everything on wheels in the shop means I can move everything around as needed. So yeah, this is a lot easier, and I can move my desk. So basically this just slides in. Spoke too soon when I said easy. There we go. And put these guys back in. Got my PC and my Mac and power. A little squeaky. All right, let's see. Put that here. Lift it up. Oh yeah, probably need to turn it on, huh? All right. There we go. Got a nice 5K display. My old MacBook Pro 15-inch display. Yeah, works pretty well. Then I could switch it to my PC, which I have down over here. You can see I had some Steam games up and Twitch. games, I turn the resolution down to probably like, I don't know, 2K or something. But it works well. It's only 60 hertz. It's not really a gaming monitor, but yeah, it works for not super hardcore gaming.
So the two apps I'm using to control my monitors, especially the 5K one, via software, is Monitor Control and Display Buddy. Monitor Control is useful because I can have it start at login, and then I can actually control the brightness with my keyboard, and whichever display my mouse is on is the display that it controls the brightness on. So that's pretty cool. So I can control the brightness on all three displays, and the way I switch between them is just put my mouse on the one I'm trying to change the brightness on, and then I hit the keys on my keyboard. And it's just like the standard way you control brightness on a Mac, which is nice. Display Buddy is nice because it gives me the ability to switch inputs with my keyboard. So if I do Control 1 or Control 2, it switches between my PC and my Mac without me having to use the remote, which is kind of handy to be able to switch between two computers. This one has the ability to also do brightness, but it wasn't really working very well, so I only use Display Buddy for the keyboard shortcuts, and then I use Monitor Control for the brightness control. And I think there's one also for PC that I haven't really delved into yet. I'll put it in the description as well, if you're on PC and you want to be able to control it via software. So that'll be an option as well. So it also has some things up here, so you can also control it up here. And yeah, I have both of these start when the computer turns on, so they're automatically loaded, and they work really well.
That's pretty much it. All right, well, yeah, I hope you liked it. If you have any questions, leave me a comment, or if you have any suggestions for the V3, how I can make this better, or any aspect, really. All the things I ordered and printed and made are available online. In the description, you'll find some links. Like and subscribe if you want to see more. That's pretty much it. Now it's time to think about V3. I do kind of want to paint this border black. It's just bare metal. I think it would look nicer. There already is a little bit of painted black, but it's, I don't know why they didn't do the whole thing. That'll look nice. Yeah, let me know. What do you guys think? How can this be better? Also, should I make a stand so that it doesn't require the arm? I don't know. Yeah. All right. Pretty much it. All right.